The spacecraft will soon be flying. One of the latest updates from Elon Musk suggests that flight the 9th of May launch next week. The rapid progress of the system is in line with this schedule. However, FAA approval is still unclear. At the same time, Musk is gearing up for a major presentation at Starbase. In other developments, SpaceX has successfully achieved a major reusability milestone with its Falcon 9 rocket. The reason for the IM-2 lander failure has now been revealed. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. We will discuss all of these topics in depth. Get ready for Flight 9. After a long period of excitement and speculation, the highly anticipated next chapter for Starship is upon us. Several recent updates suggest that the highly anticipated flight, the 9th of May, be set to take off this month. As anticipation continues to build, fans are eagerly awaiting an official announcement from SpaceX, Elon Musk, or the FAA. The excitement surrounding this potential news is palpable. We now have the most direct indication yet from Musk himself. In addition to his brief but informative tweet about the upcoming flight, Musk then provided a more comprehensive message. In anticipation of next week's Starship flight, I am scheduled to deliver a company presentation detailing the company's Mars strategy at Starbase in Texas. The event will also be available to viewers via livestream on X. Let's take a moment to focus on the first segment of that tweet. Ahead of next week's scheduled Starship flight, there is a clear confirmation. If Elon Musk's statement proves accurate, we can anticipate a launch scheduled for the fourth week of May, specifically between the 19th and 25th. This effectively coincides with other recent declarations and indications of preparations underway at Starbase. This is significant progress. After a gap of about 2.5 months since the conclusion of Flight 8, SpaceX seems fully confident that Flight 9 is ready to launch. Frankly, that period may be significant. Each Starship test flight contributes to a series of improvements. In preparation for such a large and complex launch vehicle requires careful and deliberate effort. The hardware is showing significant progress. Consider the S-35, which served as the upper stage for Flight 9. On May 12th, it reached a major milestone with the successful completion of a powerful static firing test involving 6 engines. SpaceX recently marked the milestone on social media, announcing that Starship had successfully completed a long-duration static firing test using 6 engines. The spacecraft is now in the final stages of preparation for its upcoming 9th test flight. Musk shared his reflections, expressing awe at the incredible forces at play. Considering the massive amounts of energy flowing through the rocket's engines, it's remarkable that they don't explode every time they launch. That level of confidence isn't taken for granted, highlighting the impressive performance of Starship systems as they transition into this upcoming phase. Following the completion of the static fire test, S-35 was transported from Massey back to Megabay 2 on the morning of May 13th. The vehicle is currently undergoing a thorough inspection to assess its condition after the rigorous testing process. The team is currently in the process of preparing to install the flight termination system and payload. Assuming all goes according to schedule, completion of these tasks is anticipated by the end of this week. After this, S-35 is expected to be transported to the launch pad early next week. At the same time, Musk suggested that a launch could occur. Meanwhile, B-14 has successfully taken its designated position. On the evening of the 12th, the rocket was transported to the launch pad, where it was positioned onto the orbital launch cradle the following morning. The two major components of the vehicle are nearly ready for assembly. In addition to the upgrades made to the spacecraft and boosters, improvements are also being made to various ground systems. A new vertical vent pipe has been installed, and the vaporizer has been upgraded to increase capacity to hold more propellant. Significant upgrades introduced before Flight 9. These adjustments mark the culmination of the pre-launch phase. Once S-35 reaches the launch pad and is safely positioned above B-14, a comprehensive wet dress rehearsal will likely occur. This will serve to confirm the countdown sequence and fuel loading process. While it has not been confirmed whether these tests will occur, given SpaceX's strong focus on safety and performance, incorporating them would be a wise decision. While there is an air of optimism surrounding the launch, it is important to note that SpaceX has not released any official statement regarding the timeline for the upcoming launch. The FAA continues to play a critical role, but there has been an unexpected twist in the situation. In the latest development, the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, is continuing its investigation into the Flight 8 incident, while SpaceX has yet to provide a comprehensive report detailing the flight incident. This has come as a surprise to many, especially considering that Flight 8's failure was very similar to the issues experienced by Flight 7, whose investigation was recently completed last month. The ongoing investigation into Flight 8 suggests that there may be underlying or less obvious issues that are still under investigation. SpaceX has a history of proceeding with upcoming launches, even when the previous flight is still being analyzed. The FAA has historically allowed these types of flights to proceed, contingent on assurances of public safety. For example, Flight 8 took off even as the investigation into Flight 7 was still ongoing. However, SpaceX still needs to get final authorization from the FAA before proceeding with the launch of Flight 9. The critical investigation now centers on whether Flight 9 will take off as Musk has suggested next week. The timeline depends on several factors: the speed at which SpaceX completes hardware preparations, the timeliness of the FAA review process, and the status of all systems leading up to launch. Given the current momentum, the launch window seems more likely, with a projected date between May 19th and May 25th. What do you think? Are you confident that Flight 9 will take place next week? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. Please answer with a yes or no, and feel free to explain your reasoning. Be sure to hit the like button on the video and subscribe to our channel to stay informed with all the latest updates on SpaceX's progress. With the Starship launch just around the corner, you don't want to miss a moment. Now let's turn our focus to a major announcement made by SpaceX. Musk will be delivering a highly anticipated presentation at Starbase in Texas, where he will discuss the latest developments his company has made. Musk officially announced the highly anticipated event with a live statement, stating, "I'll be there next week." The upcoming discussion will be streamed live on X and will center on one of the most audacious goals in human history, establishing a sustainable presence on Mars. For those who follow SpaceX, it's clear that Starbase presentations have been a consistent feature for the past few years. Last year's event was filled with comprehensive updates featuring in-depth information on the progress of various iterations of Starship, the advancements made on the Raptor engines, and even the ambitious criteria for establishing a settlement on Mars. These revelations sparked widespread conversation within the space community and continue to inspire speculation and analysis to this day. This time around, the focus is expected to shift to SpaceX's ambitious plans for Mars exploration. Musk has hinted at upcoming missions to Mars, both crewed and uncrewed, including the Optimus uncrewed mission, tentatively set to take place towards the end of next year. Given the scope and complexity of the missions at hand, the upcoming discussions will play a significant role in defining SpaceX's strategy for preparation. From launch frequency to the intricacies of life support systems, there are many components to this complex puzzle that enthusiasts and specialists alike are eagerly awaiting to perfectly align. Beyond Mars, the event will likely provide insight into a number of other important advancements. For example, when can we expect the launch of Starship 5-3 and the Raptor 3 engines? How soon will we see a flight-capable iteration of the enhanced crew transportation system? What are the projected dates for the upcoming uncrewed Starship missions? Also, how will SpaceX adjust its strategy following the FAA's authorization for up to 25 launches per year from Starbase and approval of the expansive Starbase City Development Initiative? Without a doubt, this presentation is poised to offer more than just an update on Mars exploration. These developments have the potential to change our expectations for Starship, SpaceX infrastructure, and the future of human spaceflight in the years to come. As anticipation for the highly anticipated Flight 9 grows, it's important to remember that next week's events are just as important in understanding the broader context. As always, we'll be here to bring you the most exciting updates. But there was more to report in SpaceX news this week. The company has reached a significant new milestone in its ongoing pursuit of rocket reusability, specifically with the Falcon 9. On the 13th at 1:02 a.m. Eastern Time, SpaceX successfully launched a Falcon 9 rocket from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center. The mission was notable for carrying 28 Starlink satellites into orbit. The successful deployment of these satellites marked a significant accomplishment. However, the real story began to emerge on the ground. In a remarkable display of resilience, the booster used on this mission, designated B-1067, weathered adverse weather conditions while achieving an impressive 28th landing. This time aboard the drone known as Just Read the Instructions, we embarked on a unique journey. This achievement marked the 120th JRT landing in SpaceX recovery of all six boosters, further advancing its remarkable streak of reusability. Most importantly, B-1067 has set a new milestone, achieving the highest number of landings with a single booster globally, with a total of 28 and counting. SpaceX quickly took to social media to celebrate the significant milestone, announcing the leading Falcon booster successfully completed its 28th launch and landing. Elon Musk also chimed in, enthusiastically stating, 28 launches and landings with the same booster. For context, B-1067 accomplished this feat less than a month after its last landing on April 1st. Such a quick turnaround time is almost unprecedented in rocketry, showcasing the incredible efficiency, precision, and durability inherent in the Falcon 9 design. As many fans know, the ultimate goal is to achieve the incredible milestone of zero launches and landings with just one booster. With only 12 flights left, B-1067 is making significant progress. And if SpaceX maintains its current pace, this milestone could be achieved sooner than anticipated. But why is this significant? The answer lies in the fact that it represents more than just a record. It serves as evidence of a significant shift in the way spaceflight is operated. SpaceX's commitment to full reusability has dramatically reduced costs, accelerated launch schedules, and increased accessibility to space like never before. The Falcon 9 has established itself as the backbone of the commercial launch sector, thanks to its impressive reliability and adaptability. Milestones like B-1067's 28th flight further solidify SpaceX's lead over its competitors in the industry. As we look to the future, let's increase our support for B-1067 and the entire Falcon fleet. Their accomplishments have not only transformed the economics of spaceflight, they have also contributed to and funded SpaceX's overarching mission of enabling human life on multiple planets. Stay tuned for more news and developments on Starbase, Flight 9, and what's next. In today's closing news segment, we bring you an important update on the Intuitive Machines IM-2 mission. In March, the Athena lander sustained significant damage when it flipped over during a landing near the Moon's South Pole. Upon arrival, the lander's solar panels were misaligned, making them ineffective at capturing sunlight. As a result, the lander was rendered inoperative within 2 hours. After conducting extensive analysis over 2 months, Intuitive Machines identified several key factors that contributed to the situation. The initial problem involved a malfunction in the Athena laser altimeter system. This component experienced signal interference during descent, resulting in incorrect altitude measurements. Additionally, the unique lighting conditions present at the lunar south pole, characterized by low-angle lighting, along with rugged terrain and greatly reduced visibility, presented significant challenges for the lander's navigation system. These challenges were further compounded by the reliance on optical navigation, which relied on high-altitude images taken by NASA Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. Unfortunately, these images did not accurately depict the appearance of surface features when viewed during a low-altitude approach under the same lighting conditions. The IM-2 mission, which was a component of NASA Commercial Lunar Payload Servicing Initiative, included two secondary payloads, a hopper named GRACE and Lunar Outpost MAP, also known as MAP Rover. However, due to the fall of Athena, none of these payloads could be deployed. Given the current challenges, Intuitive Machines is leveraging insights gained from previous missions, IM-1 and IM-2, to improve the design and performance of future landers. Preparations for IM-3 are progressing rapidly ahead of launch, set for 2026 aboard a SpaceX Falcon 9. Having gained better insight into the challenges faced by the lunar south pole, the company is actively improving its hardware and software systems to increase the chances of success for future missions. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.